Hey there, broken salespeople. My name is Red Stafstrom. Welcome to the workshop, and we are here to help you fix your broken sales skills. Today, I want to talk about a subject that I've always really enjoyed, personality profiling. Understanding the way people think, the emotions that motivate them, the way to speak to each person the best way. This has always been one of my favorite topics because once you understand personality profiles and the way people want to be spoken to and the way you can tailor a message to get them the most engaged, the better off you're going to be. See, you can spot read a person eventually. Once you understand personality profiles and how people react, you can spot read and figure out the way to speak to them to make them the most excited about what you're actually offering. It's the idea of you're speaking my language, but not in a English, French, Spanish kind of way. Being on the same wavelength, because each person is a little bit different, true, but there are some patterns that emerge. Now, I grew up in the 90s. I was born in 86, which makes me a massive Ninja Turtle fan. Diehard Ninja Turtle fan, in fact. The nostalgia of it alone. Now, I know that sounds like a left turn to some of you, but it's actually one of the best ways to understand personality profiles. See, there have been four personalities for most of human history. The ancient Greeks had four personality profiles based on the fluids in a person's body, yellow bile, black bile, blood, and phlegm. These levels, depending on how much you had of each, was said to dictate your personality. People who tended to be very angry, very forceful, tended to have a lot of blood, according to the ancient Greeks. Is it true? Absolutely not. It means nothing. But that was the theory that they proposed. Those four fluids, those four humors, is what they were called, wound up being carried down over the generations. And now it's mostly used in the DISC personality profile. If you aren't familiar with the DISC, that's what this episode is about. It's about giving you the penny tour of DISC. I highly recommend you do some tests. I know Tony Robbins has a great tool on his website that's completely free. I recommend you doing it. It can tell you a lot more about yourself. But understanding the DISC, these four profiles will help you spot read a customer, understand what they're looking for, and be able to speak to them the way they want to be spoken to. So DISC breaks down into four different personalities. There's the dominant, the influence, the steady, and the conscientious. Conscientious. Now, these four personalities you see over and over and over again, especially in pop culture. It's kind of one of those secrets of a writer's room. Once you learn these four profiles, you'll start noticing it over and over again. Now, I'm going to use Ninja Turtles because I think that's one of the most blatant examples of the DISC, but you can also carry this on to the Fantastic Four, Seinfeld, Scooby-Doo. You can see it in Big Bang Theory. You can see it in a lot of different places, but I think Ninja Turtles, they really solidify these four personalities very, very well. But I'll talk about some of the others that I mentioned too. So let's go through them. Dominant, influence, steady, conscientious. D is the dominant personality. This makes up about 3% of all human beings, which is good because D personalities can be assholes. I'm one. The D personality tends to be not so much people-oriented, but very task-oriented and more on the extroverted side of the spectrum. So if you think of a simple grid, four blocks, one right, like two on two, put D up at the top, and along the top, write task, people, and then the task at the top, people at the bottom, extrovert on the right, influence on the left. D is in the top right, extrovert, task-oriented. Tend to be more outgoing. Now, these are not hard and fast rules. In fact, I am one of the 20% of high D personalities who is also an introvert. There are very few. This makes me about 0.6% of the overall population for you stat nerds. There aren't many introverted D's and introverted I's. The introverted D is probably the smallest population of all of them, just so you guys know. So the dominant personality, that's like Raphael, if you're familiar with Ninja Turtles. Little Brass, very direct, blunt, task-oriented, just go, 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 go. Let's just do it. That's the high D personality. You could also see it, Donald Trump. I'm not going to get down that rabbit hole, but he is a classic high D personality. He is very driven in terms of what he wants and can be very abrasive to some people. I'm not saying all high Ds are abrasive, but they're the most likely to be, quite frankly. You could also think of them as eagles, like eagles the bird. Very direct. They think they're majestic, at least. I know I'm not. I own a mirror. You can't lie to me. But generally speaking, most Ds tend to be people who are seeking high positions. Doesn't mean they always thrive in them, but they're generally the people who go for them the most. In the other shows, high D personalities, you could think of The Thing with Fantastic Four, Clobber in Time. Elaine Benes with Seinfeld. And what was the other one? Oh, Scooby-Doo. Fred with Scooby-Doo. He's very direct, very as a leader. Let's go get him. He's the one who yanks the mask off. That's the high D personality. The high I personality is the parrot. They're bright, colorful, talkative. Also sometimes distracted by shiny objects. Michelangelo, the party dude. These are the people who can go to a bar for 2 hours, talk to a bar stool for 20 minutes, and get the bar stool to go home with them. Most real estate agents and most salespeople fall into this category. They aren't always the most task-focused. They don't like updating their CRM, for instance. But they tend to build relationships very quickly with people. They're very quick with a joke. They're very easygoing. They're easy to talk to for long periods of time. This is the majority of, again, salespeople. It's the personality that lends itself to sales because you don't necessarily mind being out in the open, being in front of a large group, stumbling a little bit. You're typically a high extrovert, an extroverted, people-focused person. You probably have a very wide extended friends group as a high I personality. All of these are great things. What you can lack is a little bit of the discipline. The high D can lack some of the tact, the relationship. So all of these personalities have strengths and weaknesses, and then at the end I'll go through how you address those. So Michelangelo is a high I personality. The Human Torch, high I personality. Scooby and Shaggy, high I personalities. Kramer, high I personality. All of these guys, people focused, bright, colorful, draw people in, fun to be around, crack a lot of jokes, but not always the most disciplined. This is the one downside that most salespeople fall into, is they're great with people, but don't always have the discipline to follow it up. They may spend more time in the back room laughing as opposed to making the calls that they were supposed to. It's happened to all of us. It's happened to me. It's just the way things kind of are. The S is the steady type personality. Think of these as the office moms. These are the doves. Want things to be peaceful, harmonious. Want everybody to get along very well. This is Leonardo. Now, I know you could think Leonardo is highly task-focused too, but he focuses a lot in terms of keeping the family together. And that's what the S personality is focused on. I'm a high D personality. My wife is a high S. We work very well together because we are opposites. I know that sounds weird, but she actually softens me up and I get her to be a little more forceful. I get her to stand up for herself. A lot of marriages wind up working this way with two separate personalities. If you're a high I salesperson, you probably have a very detail-oriented spouse. I'll get into that in a minute too. Look at these X's. So top right D, bottom right I, bottom left S, top left C. So the S personalities, Donatella, or the S personalities is Leonardo being the leader. You could also look at Velma with Scooby-Doo, or not Velma, Daphne with Scooby-Doo. She's kind of the mom. She's the one I assume is with Fred all the time. I'm just going to make some wild assumptions there. You could also see Jerry as the high S personality. He's the one that everybody crowds around. You don't see many scenes with just Elaine and Kramer, do you? Everybody kind of huddles around Jerry. This is also Sue Storm in the Fantastic Four. Sue is the mom. She's the one who keeps everybody together. She's the heart and soul of the group. She's the one that makes sure everybody gets along very well. That's the S personality, the steady personality, the office mom, the dove. The last one is C, the conscientious personality. Obviously, that leaves Donatello. Detail-oriented, task-oriented, introverted. Accountants, researchers, scientists, IT professionals. People who are like being lost in their work and lost in their work by themselves. Don't really like group projects. This is probably a lot of your valedictorians in high school. The people who really just buckled down and studied. They like knowing all the details. They like knowing how things work, how things fit together. They want to know everything about everything. They are driven by mastery. They are driven by knowing the fine details. You could also see Velma. George is very much somebody who sweats the details in Seinfeld. Reed Richards, world famous scientist, obviously. Donatello, as I said, you can see these personalities in a lot of ways. Odds are you fit in one of these overall. That doesn't mean you don't jump between them on occasion too. Don't think it's that rigid. If you're a parent, you've had to be a high D personality. If you have kids, you've had to be forceful. You've also had to be the soft one once in a while, the S. You adjust based on what you need at that moment, but you just have one preferred style overall. So don't think that these are set in stone. Once you identify how the person is, how the other person likes to be, their natural personality style, it's up to you to figure out how to speak to them. Luckily, it's very simple. Once you have that personality in mind, who they remind you of out of the people I already spoke to, now you can start addressing them. If you're speaking to a high D personality, a high D, a dominant personality, get right to the point. Don't worry them with fluff. This is what you need to know. Boom, boom, boom. Here's what you'll like. A, B, C. Here's what you won't like. A, B, C. Done. Be very direct with them, very short. Answer the question that was asked. Sometimes, I'm always hesitant to say this, but people always say the only thing an alpha respects is a bigger alpha. I don't believe that's true. I think that's overly simplistic. They respect another alpha. You don't have to be bigger. You don't have to be tougher, but you do have to stand up for yourself. You have to be very blunt, very direct. Tell them exactly what you're thinking and be very honest with them. I'm not saying you shouldn't be honest with everybody, but expediency counts with a high D. They don't have the patience for a lot of details. High I personalities, they want to be liked. They want to get along with everybody. They want you to laugh at their jokes. Now, again, that's true for everybody, so I'm oversimplifying here, but it's going to show higher returns with a high I personality. They like to be that center of attention. They like to be bright, colorful, and talkative. Give them the opportunity to do that. Take some time before you get down to business with a high I. Build that relationship a little bit more because they're going to value it more than anything else. The S personality, the steady personality, the Leonardos, they want things to stay status quo. They want things to run smoothly. When you speak to them, talk about relationships, build relationships, and how you're going to make sure that everything goes smoothly. That's what matters to them. Speak to the relationship, the making sure that it's not going to create waves. That's what the high S likes to hear. The high C personality, they want to know all the details. They're the ones who show up onto the car lot with a clipboard. They're the ones who check all the tires, make sure the air is right. They want to know everything. They're checking fuel mileage. They're researching. They've got a pile of consumer reports. They're going on 50 test drives. High C personality wants information. Give it to them. Give them the statistics. Give them everything they need to know. Encourage them. Give them sources. Honestly, hey, those are some great places to go, but have you tried this one? This is where I point a lot of my customers to when they really love it. Give them those resources. They love those resources. Give them books to read. Give them homework assignments. When I'm talking to a C personality, I always mention three or four books that I'm reading or have read. As they come up in conversation, I say, hey, have you read Drive by Daniel Pink, Quiet by Susan Cain, Permission to Screw Up by Kristen Hadid, Infinite Game by Simon Sinek? I love, because they are information focused, I love giving them new places to find information. Do the same thing when you meet that Donatello out in the wilderness. Give them those options. Once you learn these skills, once you can spot a person based on these personalities, it makes it so much easier to speak their language and build that common bond, because you are speaking the way they like to be spoken to. Moves things along a lot quicker. So I know this is a longer one than I usually do. I hope you guys enjoyed. I hope there's been tons of great information here. If you have any more questions, let me know. I'm here to help. If you go to brokensalespeople.com/connect, you could find me on all the platforms. You can also support my Patreon. I don't keep a single dime from Patreon. That is purely to get the message out there, help more people find the sales training that could help take them to the next level. Every dollar that goes to Patreon helps get the message out there and hopefully help somebody else the way I'm hopefully helping you out. Consider donating and passing it along. So again, brokensalespeople.com/connect. I hope to see you guys again on the next podcast. Make sure you are subscribed. Please leave a review. brokensalespeople.com/connect. Until next time, thank you for listening to the Broken Salespeople podcast. I'm Red Staffstrom, and please, go fix yourself.